Right, Fambulem. Warm, warm welcome to everybody. With global audience and listeners there. Very, very happy today, the 20th of November 2020. This is a very special edition for a very special reason. Yesterday we got a program, obviously, and that was the health program. But when it comes on politics, you see, you know, the interest of the people, which is very good. So anyway, let me not waste time anymore. Let me just get down straight to the issue. So I want to begin with the picture of one of the watching on the background. Of course, this is a very, very iconic photograph of a former and a present. Former president, now president. But despite what we see so now the photo, it seems like everything else is fake. Today, we need it means we was. And soon I know saying that this platform, waiting within half for talk, now nothing but the truth. So help me God. So when you see the photo there, when this photo will come out, now because there were issues around now the country. Now, Lord, don't forget, because they can take me for granted. This now State House, we released this photo some many months ago. And the way certain things that may go on, for assure we the people, allay with fears, then provide we with this photo for sure saying, despite all what you would remember, all what you would think, all what you would see and hear, a large number of it was untrue. So therefore, they released this photo to we, and it was a very good photo up because that helped for calm nerves, both domestically and internationally. So we all glad it. But many months on, the tension continued for rise in the country. And the tension will continue for rise now the country is as a consequence of then two individuals that we will look at, both the former president and the current president. Okay, as a consequence of the action, we don't know whether or not dislike for each other, we don't know whether or not game, we don't know whether or not whatever, but for some reason, we the people continue for be at the brunt of the action of two powerful men. Not too long ago, the presidency of Ernest Bai Koroma being the create pathway for development and progress, social justice, and you name it. A three years on us now, they don't lost power, and we now have the current leader, retired Brigadier Julius Madabio, His Excellency, where during this administration, would they see many things they unfold? Will make me for title this program here today. The GOSL, is it ineffective, inefficient, or both? When I put the flyer out on social media to the general public, of course, the usual suspect them. Without due diligence, I guess we'll talk about this a little bit, Pamulem. Will they come to the main point? Senior Mo, welcome to the program. Well, Mr. Superman Mohamed Kamara, welcome to the program, brother. So when I put out the title, of course, because we all now one, despite the political differences, some can get the courage for call or send messages. Some now ask, they can ask, others they can want just provoke issues. Others, they can show so much degree of ignorance is unbelievable that you ask a question and not waiting, you know, here for hear the content, and you already don't make judgment. And when you make the judgment, it's so powerful. So let's deal with this today, you know, in the context of effective or inefficient or even both. So for let me understand this, Fambulem, we know what we actually suppose for do. And what we need for do now for look into their words there and see how applicable they are in terms of the wider context in which they were used or as per the title. So for begin with, let me look at what in ineffectiveness. Of course, ineffectiveness means way something not effective. So the opposite will be, if something is effective, the opposite will be ineffective. And if it's ineffective, which means that it's not working. So ineffectiveness in this case, we are they talk about, if they try to describe something where not they work, Not to altogether let we get this right. You see, now the context is, but something we been anticipate say will work, but it not work very well. So in governmental circles, something when they work very well, we always almost all the time can happen. Now something where we can readjust. You know, we try this in our work, so we try this other one, try this way, try that way until we get them right. Not often, because you first of all they enact policies, but we'll come to that anyway. But ineffectiveness means something we need to work very well, or it get little effect as per the desire effect. Pambulem, the issue of ineffectiveness having little desired effect as per the expected desired effect. So inefficient means the thing that we need to put good use to we things that when we anticipate say, suppose for work for we example we get with resources them, and this not only attributed to this government, I guess they speak generally, but we resources they not tend for the work for we, even though we hear all this massive talk, big talk and blame games. So the last time we not work for we, waiting we were made to understand is this is what we are going to do. We are going to make this thing work for the Sierra Leonean people. The resources which rightfully belongs to you will work in your interest. 3 years on, it's not working, Fambulen. Let me call a spade, straight on, it's not working. Fambulen, they ask you now, then, please don't be selfish. Let me share this video, please. We want people then for join the program. We know say the interaction can be a sort of problem because there are thousands of us, and because we know they on 7 days a week or 3 days a week. But this is not some emergency broadcast, and this is related to waiting to happen right now in terms of the ACC and the former president, Ernest Bai Koroma, waiting to unfold in our country. So we talk about ineffectiveness because now the title of the program down there, along with an other word what we call inefficient. Remember, we say inefficient and ineffective are both. We would point finger at the government of Sierra Leone. So inefficiency can occur when government action, they create an action way inefficient. So government, they take an action where the outcome of that action they happens for being inefficient. Now, Fambu Lebefuna, I don't get me well, because I'm very convinced, you know, you say I don't make the submission, not in its entirety, but enough for let people understand that there is a degree of inefficiency, plenty of it, inefficiency. There is a degree of ineffectiveness. So in inefficiency, when government in action, the way it don't take over these 3 years, or almost approaching 3 years, if we try for the exact, the outcome has been inefficient. So how efficient could this government be when the outcomes have been inefficient? So I mean, just want to break down the title. I hope say Pambulem Una they get that loud and clear. Okay. When government fail, okay, for perform actions the way it promised for perform, that they create problem for its people, its citizenry. It creates serious problem, serious deviation. But sometimes government they can do that deliberately. Not they accuse this one of doing that, but based on the failure on parts of government, they can decide to drive a wedge between the people in which waiting them say it becomes some kind of a propaganda in which now you've got the left and the right, or you get people on either side. We just cannot agree because you get some, we just believe everything what the government is saying, where others don't believe what the government is saying, or are a bit skeptical of what the government is saying. And the thing, the common denominator, younger, we're supposed to convince people them say, well, what the government, they tell us, they work. Now, by virtue of the action we then take, it gets a desired effect, a result, and the people are feeling it. If you raise wages, people will fulfill the consequence of that wage raise they inside their pocket. When they go buy, therefore understand what they buy and the effect of the goods and services where they reach them or where they aspire for. If it's not the case, it's as simple as ABC, one, two, three, that it is not effective. It is not efficient. So people then go continue for complain. Fabule, government in failure and not depend where he creates some sort of leeway in which few of his citizens then will be better off. We then can normally use as an example for tell other people and say, you see, this is the progress that we are making. This is not the way it's measured at all. It's not about winners and losers. It's about the state. It's not about making some people then better while some other people then get worse. Of course, that's a trial, but that's not what the case is. Their action can only be successful and the results of government action where it creates an outcome which we go consider very, very efficient. Now, where the state machinery, they work well, and we people are better off, are living far off and above the standard, then healthcare, then education, good education, then picking them healthcare, social justice, and many more others that I could name on and on. But family, this is not the case. I will come back to that briefly. I want to know, say, I definitely will come back to this because we'll talk about this thing here tonight. And we need to understand this. And the reason why I bring this come up is because waiting 10 for the play out now with country right now between these two gentlemen, it seems like a game and I want to deal with now. I've been called an ineffective and inefficient because when you lump that into the equation, you see exactly where I am coming from. How efficient is government? How effective is government? So now just for add the IN into the efficient and the effective and either become non-sustainable. So the former leader, Ernest Bai Koroma, has been invited to the ACC on a number of occasions now, much to the chagrin of people away, sort of they support the party and some of the actions and largely the actions of the government. While some of us remain skeptical and they watch and try to be very, very objective or look at waiting to happen. But here is the case. Like I say, on a number of occasions, the former president has been invited for go answer questions of corruption, embezzlement, money laundering, and etc. But what we see over a number of period now, or number of times where they don't invite the former president, is disappointment, huge disappointment, which makes this particular government of Julius Maada Bio weak. Ladies and gentlemen, did you hear me say weak? W-E-A-K, in fact, the W with a capital, because you are indecisive, because you are ineffective, because you are inefficient, because you are incompetent, putting the lives of the people at risk. Putting the lives of the people at risk on a daily basis. And some people then think say, this is not a joke, for compromise the lives of 7.5 million Sierra Leoneans just for satisfying the ego of certain individuals. Why did I say this? Here we go. Welcome, Sister Janet. Welcome to the program. Of course, it's indecisive, ineffective behavior in terms of decision-making. And this is what I'm speaking to. I thank you that the sister we just joined, catch the Maponi as quickly as possible. This is why it is, because now in Sierra Leone, as soon as you want to talk about something, you know, yeah, we sort of academic, you know, in which you try to provoke a debate. If the government is inefficient and you try to make the case as to why it's inefficient, why not give chance for listening? And if you get a case, why not call the platform and let's have a conversation instead of you already this spill out, you know, yeah, some vitriol out of somewhere where I can't name. So the government has been found wanting, weak, inefficient, and incompetent, and can't even take action And yet this comes at the peril of the Sierra Leonean people. Now, here is the case, Pambulen. Let's get this straight, because this is not something we don't get to meet for a while. I kind of relax, you know, yeah, they listen and they look and they watch as things they unfold with the hope that finally some things that they will put behind we, and then we all join in nation building, let we raise we nation to higher heights. But it's not the case, because it seems like clearly some people are playing games with the lives of Sierra Leonean people, and it's our duty, you know, here to call that out. And this is exactly what I plan on doing here tonight, okay? Now, here is it. The former president, of course, when I don't accuse them, there are a couple of questions as to what is going on, because we all sort of confused. But until we know to legal minds and lawyers then, but we get a mind of our own, and we can read basic English, basic documents, we can. So there was a commission of inquiry. We already don't conduct an investigation. We don't submit a report to the government in the form of a white paper. That means that's a decision that they are taking, and it left for the president to read them and execute them. But yet we see something else being introduced. I'm not going to go into that because I'm not sure where I stand on that. But I just want to say the Commission of Inquiry be not doing work done, don't make a submission. And the courts, based on the president, be supposed to act on that, waiting up in the president in take on and wait submit the white paper to her. Yet we see other investigations being opened, and this is where we, the Sierra Leonean people, get confused, because they are telling us that there is a body or an institution called the ACC. Of course, the body does exist, the ACC, and you get this unlimited power for investigate acts of corruption, you know, your criminal acts, because the COI in itself could not conduct criminal investigations. Which brings us to the question, why did you bring the COI in the first place? When we know, say, from that very beginning, they were going to investigate issues of corruption. Why did you spend billions of Sierra Leonean money, you know, yeah, on an institution where you bring from outside, a body of people that we bring from the outside for can't conduct an investigation? What should have been the logic behind this? Where the ACC now get for continue and we read all kind of acts according to the Constitution of Sierra Leone, Act Number 8, creates this, the ACC, you know, Act Chapter X and Y and Z, just for baffle we and confuse we. Haven't we seen more confusion already? But here is the thing again, Pambulen. So, on an issue, this is irresponsible, and we have to call it out as it is. It's really no voice on my side. Philip Pabs Samora, no voice on my side. Let me ask the rest of the people, because no voice on my side. Fambule Bodia, una confirm for me whether una they get me voice. Somebody just complains and they get me voice. I mean, are they in the elements tonight, Mr. Samora? Make a few somehow, compromising the lives of 7.5 million people. Absolutely, Sister Janet. But rubbish. But I sure say, since the sister reacted, which means that people are getting my voice. Well, just for this starting, Fatma Tasseri, thank you very much, Sister. Fatma Tasseri, they gave me voice. And Brother Pabs, if you know they gave me voice, make a known again. Maybe you can do something about that. I am audible, Sister Asana, too. Many thanks. So here is the thing. So they invite the president, the former president, EBK, we're not for the first time. And guess what in the happen? So the headquarters, the HQ, I mean, there's so much to talk about that I seem for the flow out, but it's not a problem. We can flow out and flow in. The HQ of the ACC is in central Freetown, Gloucester Street, for goodness sake. Okay? And this is where I suspect that it all sounds like a game. If this is not a game, somebody please tell me what is going on. Because now two ways I see them. It's a game, but it's a game in which some man in the title look like macho men, that their ego they play out, that they summon a former president at a place and time inside they want them, which is nothing wrong per se. But if there are obstacles along the way, why cannot the venue be changed? That's one. Why cannot everything else around this proceeding, if you badly want to hear from this ex-president, cannot change? In fact, would I let me bear in mind that the former president don't already tell the general public, this is not a secret. The former president don't tell the general public that he is willing for, talk to the ACC, comply that the world war they look for. The former president has said publicly that he willing for comply with the ACC. But within the same scope, that he will use everything within his means for defend in good name. There is nothing wrong with that. If you stand accused, that's what you will do. And the man, I believe, gets unremitting resource, you know, yeah, for go and do what he did do, hire a public lawyer then, even foreign lawyers there if he wants. He's got enough money, enough dosh for do that. So, you know, say the man, not ordinary. I hear some public commentary then in which it sounds almost like you want ridicule a former president. This naive people who are talk publicly and people them, they don't get time for reflect and they think that you're just the side with EBK. No, it's not siding with EBK. You're just talking or you say something where absolutely makes sense. Nobody no need for tell me that because it does make sense that if you go after a powerful person, you get for put things into place. The man is a high value target. Doing so the way I need to go about time is risking the lives of 7.5 million, then daily livelihood, both in the physical and in the non-physical sense. The physical sense is that they could potentially get hurt, like we saw in McKinney. The other non-physical side, although it gets some physical, you know, your connections, is tell me when you invite and so the tension alone way mounts on the country. It just deprives, you know, your government means of earning, like revenue generation, for example. So there is no doubt in my mind that government will have lost billions of leones on that day. Now, why would government want for lost billions of leones? We will come to that concept day pretty soon. I just want to lay on the table, family. Why will government want lost billions of leones for go after Ernest Bai Koroma? Not the first time, not the second time, not the third time. And we never say enough for go after him. I am of the opinion, and let me make this clear. I am of the opinion that anybody will eat the people of Sierra Leone them penny. Did you hear me, Pambulem? Anybody will eat the people of Sierra Leone them penny. You know, embezzle money, launder money, keep the people their money, deprive the people them of their livelihood. Okay? Such person, regardless of who they are, they have to answer questions. And I think, say, the places I most other pundits, they can make mistake. They can try for equate Dr. Ernest Bai Koroma with ordinary citizens. It's unfortunate. This is the way the thing is. We all are not equally equal. Animal Farm, did you read it? It's just real. Except you get this dystopic idea in your mind, you know, like, well, okay, I've been president because I senior pundits and they talk about, well, he was an ex-statesman. Also, he's no longer a statesman. And the people, the way they propagate this idea, you can find out, say, now people from the other side, when they make the things sound like there is a decision for drag the man into the mud. Now, if you want drag into the mud, it has to be through legitimate means. And the reason why it will not have succeeded thus far is because the means that you are engaging for drag the man in name to the mud is unconstitutional and illegitimate. That's why all the time is being challenged by lawyers, and you see he always come out on top. So I said this some time ago that you need for going to the drawing room, go redraw everything when you fail. Now let me go again because some of the police heavyweights then they speak. One of the police commander them or director the way they call Gabriel Tommy. A man with it on public record for say, a not responsible for how you understand what he is saying, what he in the say, now it matter. Very, very interesting. Very, very interesting. So, how is it in a, okay, Francis Parker, please put some more question on what is inefficient, because I just see you question, probably there was a follow-up, I just see, I mean, just come up. What do you mean by how is it inefficient? Why are you, because I've said a lot, the program is almost like 30 minutes into play. So write a direct question on what you ask about what is inefficient, because probably you not see the beginning of the program. That's why I went and describe what is inefficient and what is ineffective and how it apply to what I am saying, that the government of Sierra Leone in this regard is inefficient, ineffective, and in fact, I said both. Oh, okay, sorry, Mr. Parker. I thought that was coming to me, sir. Sorry. Anyway, just get back into my element. So, here is the thing. You see, the former president is a former president. And as for now, and I hear you, but who people that can make this mistake back? We legal jurisprudence, I think inside me 3 years of talking, I've always said this, because what bothers me most is the social justice of and for we people. That the legal jurisprudence in the country, it puts you as an innocent person until you go through the law and proven guilty before you become a convict and people will begin point finger at you. This has not been the case, and the government has been struggling. And for goodness sake, I not understand that the same police chief will say, the word what they say, me responsible for them, but are not responsible for how you, the public, or you, the listener, interpret them. This is amazing. This is really amazing. And we for those who are really come up from Fambulem, and we for the listen keenly, that a police chief will advise the general public, they say, and not bear responsibility for the way how you they interpret what he is saying, in just responsible for what he say and how he say it. That's really interesting. Really, really interesting. But here is the other thing. So the ex-president is equally being blamed. And this is where, you see, when I use the word inefficient, ineffective, or both, I even go, you know, yet further for say incompetent on the part of many other areas, either individuals or institutions, because this thing don't play up so much that there should have been a plan of action very effective enough. Remember from the beginning, I say, if it's not effective, then of course it's ineffective. If it's not efficient, then of course it's inefficient. Why? You don't try X, Y, Z, whether or not policy making, and it doesn't work, and this is where the failure of government comes, and this is where the words inefficient and ineffective comes in. And we've seen plenty of this. Inefficient and ineffective. Therefore, many occasions you don't try for bringing the former president, and then it just does not seem to be working the way how you want them. And Mr. Sepwe Sidonayaki, the member, say, well, indeed, let me say, President Marabio, the ACC boss, Mr. Francis Ben Kaifala, actually want President, ex-president Kouma. They really want to talk to him. And the last time they went to Makeni, we know what happened there. But this time, they also want to continue with the investigation because we know what happened in Makeni. And it's just not working out because you get Freetown with a population of 1.5 million people, if not more. Freetown population between 1.2, 1.5, if not more. And the vast majority of people inside that city support this man. And you they tell me as a government, you're not able to figure that out, that if you get a huge swath of a population within a population density, that you see this man and Kran Gode, but it's like saying that a kind of different message that you try for saying, because we don't know how this is going to work without, you know, yeah, some trouble, some problem. And then you want to tell the man, say, call you people and tell them, say, una not come out, una not do this, una not do that. This is the highest degree of incompetence. This is the highest degree of incompetence. And President Marabio need for take note, because some of them people are already around them, they definitely need for go. Because if not the way that they articulate this case, where the ACC they try for bring against the former president, for example, for Kango Dongna, a Gloucester State office, also a population largely supports the man. and you know the statistics, then of course you're looking for trouble, and probably it only amounts to one thing, which is a deviation from the present circumstances that the country they go in. A, economic. Two, the lack of social justice. Three, you can't name it more than social justice problem and the economic problem. This is exactly where we are in the country. And then within this time, you they insist say you want to the former president go to Gloucester Street office, and then you want to come out and make a statement say, let the people enough fall around. Where is the evidence have you got for saying that the man that you tell people and say let him come out now do? Or doesn't it occur to you that by virtue of your action then, because things are not working, the social justice problem at all, so many people feel deeply offended in Sierra Leone. The economics that they work in, we know saying that one big base down they went in and they work, a government loses direction, loses its core support base, that people they say they support you, they get a different mind. And when they see that, they play out on social media, many tapes, verifiable tapes in which people then come out and question you about their wages, their salary, be it teachers or other public servants, then they have done so. So what happens is, you know, they endear yourself to the people. So this man now, when you try to get hold of, you already they make and look like a saint. That's what Ernest Koroma is beginning to look like, despite in shortcomings, in failings as a human being. This is unbelievable. And if there is any degree of responsibility, you definitely know, say, your approach is going to be different. It's completely a failed government, Ms. Koka. It's completely failed because elections is coming soon. Tell me, what is the message where you get for who give you people then? Because election is based on messages. Except you make one up again. And even if you make them up, how is it going to translate when the people have felt it for the last 3-4 years? They don't say better no day. So here is the thing. So you chase this man, either you try to make him, you know, the man way responsible for all waiting that happen for your government, where you have not been able to turn things around. Because it don't make no sense to me at all. In fact, before una misread this, I am not saying that the former leader not for can answer question to embezzlement, money laundering, whatever the charges are. And let me remember again, let us say, the man don't say publicly that he is willing to comply with the ACC. Where does this problem lies? Look what's happening at the streets of Freetown, right now the heart of Freetown, before the temple of justice, the law court. The president and lawyer then come out and just come out argue the case, and based on waiting with the yeah, from other public people and like the police chief, for example, it seemed like the president and lawyers then were absolutely right on the issue of security. On the issue of security, it seems that they were right. But just for buttress me point, you see the kind of crowd of people where they the end the president and lawyer them, including disabled people. Disabled people, they the end the president and lawyer them. And while another completely say they were in support of the president and lawyer them, but this goes back to the bigger point that Joseph Kamara cannot call for them people there for Kawaka Bienamu. Because if you become Pankam, just know that the same thing is like, but Joseph Kamara, tell them people there, let them not come out. Does he know them? Did he ask them to come behind him? This is just we culture, it's the nature of things that us they born with the left foot, with the do. We go watch the us where they born. That two fighting ongoing, with the left, whatever we do, go watch the fighting. This is not just we culture. So for saying you they bring a heavyweight like Ernest Koroma, Dong Chong, where I feel say the president probably know, you know, yeah, put inside a faculty a long time ago and then away have forgot about this thing, because sure enough, this thing they look wrong for them, because even the supporters of the president, they now have questions, because I see many friends, you know, yeah, remember that wonderful Thursday where Anesmi is supposed to attend the court. I get talk with many, many people, including the good friend Mr. Kuchugu Koroma. We talk for about 3 hours from 1 a.m. to 4 o'clock in the morning. And I'm saying this publicly, me and Kuchugu talk. Okay? And I tell him exactly what was going to be the outcome. And I'm sure he was disappointed. But so enthusiastic was Mr. Koroma. So confident was he. And I told him, I said, bruh, left space. With waiting with the CISO that happened, you always get for left space, bruh. And it absolutely makes sense. And in the end, I prevailed many a times because perspective, na good thing. Reflection, inflection, na good thing. And the same thing that happened again. We don't see outside people that really support the president come out. They feel say when they talk on social media, that is policy. Imagine that. How much pressure set the president go there under? Because some of them, they try for influence. They feel say they're so influential that when they talk, that is policy. And when that is not carried out, it becomes a problem. We don't see situation outside and come out outright. And they were very agitated, aggressive. Some of them heap insults as well publicly, simply because waiting they want, no good away. So we see waiting they go. So even the president in lawyer get all them people in the BNM. How much more the president, the former president, where by virtue of your action when they bear fruits, that many people are suffering today. I just asked for the rate, Usa Adeso. It's 13,000 plus to £1. Come with them. Una we understand the mathematics and the exchange rate and inflation and deflation, you name it. Well, una think about them. I wish me good friend Alfred Sanko of I call it radio, they talk, Salon Cashbox, they listen. I will get for Brian Kansung that can break this down for us. Yeah. Because I'm not the figure man, me not policy man. So now I go back to policy. So the police chief, not the police chief, one of the commander them come out and make that statement there in the talk only for waiting irresponsible for, not to how in people and way in the communicator we supposed for act, we na command or maybe request, we can say at least, now if they pass over to them, they say you're not responsible for how they interpret them. So that means if the people are not interpreting well, you are willing to have a go at them. And we've seen this before. We've seen a huge mistake in McKinney. We've seen a huge mistake in Lonsa and Tombo and other places in which it was a policy of shoot first and ask questions later. Seriously? When is this going, you know, yet to kind of change? When is it going to change? Look what happened. Sylvia Blinden, Dr. Sylvia Olayinka Blinden, then just dropped the libel case against her, which is a good thing, by the way. But what you can always ask is like, what did bring about that case there in the first place? It was on the basis of suspicion. But as usual, this again, it comes to the point of inefficient and ineffective. And you just get to go back and turn the pages and see how effective this title is. Dr. Olayinka Blinden was taken into court, charged with all kinds of things in a suffering, you know, in a woman's prison. And we hear some of the things that will happen. I can't even repeat now under the conditions which she was held. Mind you, this is a person we don't serve the country very well. And we carry the highest, one of the highest titles in the country, I mean decoration in the country. We probably people like that one day go amount to something treasonous, but then you treat them as such. But on a whimsical, flimsy excuse, she was nabbed, and we see the spectacle we play inside in oh, such a disgrace. I wonder where is that interrogation officer now? Is he still in the police? Because people like Dandy, despite all of the experience, that was a sour grape, that the picture of the former president. I mean, what did that explain to we, the people, is the intent being we make people and they do waiting and they do. And I will talk about that briefly before we end this program. That you go to somebody else, you go see the picture of the former president. So Italic say that it's a law. We say you cannot fly the picture of the former president or put a picture, a photograph of Nayuose. You can't put the picture of the late Siaka Stephen Nayuose because right now it's SLPP ruling and Siaka Stephen being instilled one party democracy. You cannot put the picture of retired brigadier or brigadier general, the late Joseph Saidu Momo Nayuose because he ruled over one party and he killed a couple of people. We can't be serious if we say we want to go further. And I can go on and on and on. So what thing happened, that spectacularly, it was so sour. This police officer actually in front of rolling cameras, they run a commentary about the picture of the former president. That just give we the critical thinker them about an inside view about why did he do them. I mean, this is a mind game. We could be wrong, but put them 50-50. Why will he want to do that? Either that's what he was sent to do with than the minor, but the one way greater is he is doing that and on camera for send a message to the masters so that he will impress on them, because the whole thing is about this man called Ernest Bai Koroma, who once upon a time was the president of the Republic of Sierra Leone. So which I've spoken many times, that respect is due to who respect is deserved. Who that deserve respect, naive respect, we go give unto. So if the man deserves respect, that respect has to be given to him. If he has to be called before a court of law, then he will have to come and answer to those things. But this man don't say, he say, bro, I'm willing for comply publicly. We know this. So una tell me exactly waiting to go on. Because every time when you bring this man with school picking and then they go school, that mental state alone where they put people in at the capital is uncalled for. It's really, really uncalled for, and it seems for the continuum. If you really, it's a comedy, Mrs. Sister Janet. This is absolute comedy, and it's uncalled for. Take the former president, if you see yours about him, this is what happens anyway. I don't know what you want to try for proof, but I make a sound from the beginning. Is it about ego? That me where Sidonia, I don't know the number, na Gloucester Street, na the ACC HQ. I summon the former president, he can't sit down before me desk, and I interview him, or the idea that I pull her in there the way I want him. Is that what you are after? Because, sure enough, because of security issues, there are alternatives that you can work on. I don't even see the coordination, hence back we'll go again to the inefficient and ineffectiveness, the coordination between security forces, because normally Unago don't coordinate very well. So in the end, there is one and only one issue for deal with the issue, which is as badly as we want the man, we make sure we don't put everything into place. Another failure again is a sign of incompetence. It's a sign of how ineffective you are and how inefficient you are. These are just facts. I mean, those of you who will even oppose to the title, I mean, think for a second. Every time when I invite this man, that confusion, they don't fit up. They send letter immediately to school picking them. We pay school picking and parents them. No school today and what have you. In the meantime, we get foreign embassies than they. In the meantime, we get businesses than they. In the meantime, we anticipate for encourage outside businesses them for can invest in the country. In the meantime, the insurance policy continue to go up for businesses the way they operate in the country. Now tell me which new business will want to come to the country. How can this not any Chinese thing? There's a Chinese proverb. You ace big stone. You strain, you ace the stone. In the end, you left eye for on your foot. What was all the effort about? If you want an escroma this badly, why not build some investigative place now? Na Kailan, somewhere deep in the forest. Why not build some investigative place if you're not already did it na Bond Island? Why not go into some of these remote places and just go hold the trial day? Because if you want to hold the trial down in Freetown, the interview or whichever way you call them, imagine even if the man succeeds for go inside the office na Gloucester Street, security wise, the amount of place where you get for cordon off. And down at the business district. So you don't mind again for lose millions, if not billions of leons, just for lay hand for this man. Waiting na the economic benefits. as per that. What is the economic benefit? Because we've seen so much losses just for lay and per demand. So much losses. The COI, boku boku losses. How much we don't recoup today? Probably we need for you to make the calculation to see how much we don't recoup as opposed to how much we spend. Or probably it's not about the money that we recoup. It's about setting a precedent against corruption that if you do steal public money, you will be tried. You will be handled. You will go after you. Famulem, do you allow me to share this video when you come towards the end of the program? Roughly, we get 15 more minutes. Okay? I just want to go back over a few things again, let Famule understand clearly. Ambitious policy. Okay, let me talk about the failure now, government sector, then, or public sector, if you like. Okay? The reason why failure can happen now, the area than the public area than the inside government, now, as a consequence of many, many reasons. One of them is the lack of inspiration, of motivation from public sector servants. Does that ring a bell to you, Famulem? That the fact that if the public servants there, they are not motivated, or the allegiance, not per region, not per country, not per government, not per country and its people, not per tribe, not per country and its people, then it's obvious that the effort will fail. Not for everybody within the public sector go have the same inspiration, aspiration, motivation for work hard with kind of necessary for increased efficiency. Not to everybody. And the reason why I say not to everybody, I speak directly to this current government, because then they rule on a division in which thousands of people have lost their jobs to the cry of, well, government get discretion. They can do as they want, just like any other government when they come. What they can do now, bring their young people in. Well, bring your people all fine and well. How competent are your people? And this goes to any government. So you not just they bring you people in, you they bring them for can be effective, for carry out policies them, you work out policies them where eventually will work out for the greater good of the people. But if this is not the case, Bo, what are they use? You see political goal scoring, and this is not the point we continue to this day. We continue for fulfilling government in, government out. That's why we are asking for a change. The Sierra Leonean people need for begin for keep an eye. And when I say a change, I never talk about the current government alone. I am talking about the overall system. So not to where this go, Abdullahi Kam, and you know Ishmael's no, that's not what I'm talking about, because it's the same thing, different day, same old end up for me inside this government and previous government and all other governments before them, because this now we kind of system is we see unrealistic approach for the success of government. You say you want your government succeed now, so you tell your people then. But then the approach, the way they use, are very, very unrealistic. And because they're unrealistic, they definitely will meet nothing but failure. Nothing but failure. I have said this time and time and again on this platform, that government, past and present, they use the country in money for train civil servants, public servants, other individuals then, for help government for be effective and efficient. Millions of dollars every year government is spent. And as a consequence of that spending, people they become experts in certain fields. And over a period of time, just like a novice, from the beginning of freshman, after a while, you get occurrence of what you need to do because you get familiar with your surrounding. You know exactly what's up, what to do. What are the requirements? You become a manager, begin manage other people then. But no sooner a government changes, then bring in somebody else and you have to go. The worst is you could lose your job, and thousands, like I say, don't lost their job. So imagine you and are the expert in that area, they will understand all of this. They're not even bring an understudy, and I will come to that meeting and do well. We don't talk to, and when they try for being understudy them, the disgraceful thing will happen. But imagine you don't go. When you don't go down, they bring all these new people that come. And then in the end, what do you expect? Nothing again but failure. Nothing again you will see but inefficiency. Nothing you will see but ineffectiveness. Because in the absence of efficiency, that's when you get inefficiency. I hope so when I get the message. Because once you move people them along, and not for good reason, you know, political goal scoring, and you name it, all the skullduggery, the machinations, and you name it, that's what they do, that's what they apply all of the time. And this is not only related to this government, but I'm speaking to this government now because this is the government in power. Here is the other thing. So if these people have weighed and untrained over years from Shaka Stephen in time, because most people are supposed under Samuel Timaga and Imbona Albat, would not die. Are not sure whether President Strasser then train people them, this current president will know, or after training them definitely will take place because government na continuation. We're not sure. But let me assume that was the case. So from that 10 day onwards, here we are, we don't know, waiting and waiting don't take place. There are people that went and train and spend millions, man. Some lucky, they move them on to other side them. But imagine that. How much effective will they be to the new side they are, who side they send them to? How much effective will they be? How efficient will they be? Then new side they are with and send them so. But like I say, they could be lucky they get job. The worst one is people also with an untrain over them period of time there, where as a consequence of them policy there, by new governments they come and we get for bring with your new people. Forget say previous governments them don't spend millions and millions and millions of dollars for trained public personnel for carry out basic government duty so that they will be efficient and effective for the good of the people them. But unfortunately, these people then they allow them for go elsewhere, brain drain. As a consequence, government left empty. Fambulem, when they come to the end of this program, I want for land. You see, I mean, they talk about the way politicians them. I mean, they talk about the way politicians them. The ambitious one, they will get plenty of them. How they can set unrealistic goals them and date them. And not really looking at the risk in terms of the unrealistic goal them where they're not set and the time span where they're set. And we don't see this plenty. Hence, we'll go back to the topic, inefficient, ineffective, okay? In some cases, the quality of work is so poor, or the way that they go about for set them on realistic dates and time, is because some of their ambitious civil servants, they are one proof to the master, to the boss, how capable they are, how effective they are. And sometimes they, not to the public servant self, because I really don't want to blame the seasoned public servant them in this respect, because these are really decent people in some time gone. But speaking of now, well, I will leave that to conjecture. But the demand from the ambitious politicians them say, this is the goal, and I need them now because I need to prove to my people them. So that's an unrealistic goal, unrealistic time set, because it's not feasible within the time scope within the set. But because the boss wants and done, that civil servant get for cut corners all the way and make it happen. And then it becomes something, you know, you're winning a short term instead of long term. So if not been building because you put more sand and cement, of course, it will team up. But after a while, it becomes more disaster, a hazard to the people that we even think say you make them for, than a good. Because it will collapse on them. Luckily, maybe nobody knows what they did. That's just an example, but it can come in the form of a bridge. It can come in the form of anything, structural-wise. Okay? So for that wash day for do delivery, the real requirements we such delivery then can require are not, you know, are not attained. You don't tend to get them because everything has been rushed for satisfy a greedy and ambitious politician. Okay? You begin for deviate from reality. Because you get the realistic prospect, and then you get the fake prospect where now that pressure the way the ambitious politician they put on you. And because you set need for keep your job, you get for agree to what he say, even though you know say it's not good. But in one time anyway. And none of us say that politician may accept no. It just puts you under pressure. In other words, whichever way you want for do them, just go ahead and do them. And these are the kind of things that we see. Cronyism, nepotism are all the hallmarks of the government where we see where make things really work. Like I see the price for one pound, who started 13,000. Imagine waiting down the mean. So because of cronyism and nepotism, it block accountability or blur accountability, because maybe you didn't see them, but you know they see them fine. So like when you get cataract now you high or some you just blurring. Or deliberately you make like say you know they see, because why? Nepotism, cronyism. If they at play. Nobody don't want for any bad news. So when an election about to happen, they begin for all kinds of promises, like I can tell people them. Typical example would be the Lunge Bridge. I can talk and privately to people, but I feel very confident for saying publicly, because if it does happen, great. But before election they come, we know say we will see the light aircraft will come turn over and fly over Lunge Water, and we people then will go call it back for them. We will see probably foreign nationals, most likely Asians, come and with a tripod, you know, that thing they can use for survey all over the place. And that definitely nothing where we will see. Because why? When election they come, you begin for send changes. Because you want to send a kind of message to the people that you are a man of the people. But this is not the case. Nobody don't want for any bad news. And that they talk specifically to the politician and don't want any bad news. What they can normally do, what the public servant then they can inform them of their news there, they can cover them. Cover, they can't say no more. In the execution of a project, because the public servant they're under duress for implement a project or a policy which is not well thought out through, is bound for fail in the short term, yes, and adapt the politician day after for say, well, look at you be one see this, here it is. But it doesn't serve well because the real intent in the end is not seen. Now that continue for the happen. So we not see progress. We don't see progress at all. Finally, when you go look panic the setting, okay? Then begin for adjust here and there. It's not like where you go into panic mode, you go do an operation. If you're in panic mode, tell me if an operation you go do and you're in panic mode where you're supposed to be relaxed and focused and concentrating, there is a degree for danger. Okay, that the life where you go save in terms of that operation, you might likely lose that life there because you're not there in the mode now. Cut and put, cut ya put ya. Okay, from the level be realistic. In every democracy in the world, I can always say, politicians then they come and then they go. The thing where they remain, now we the people. And this is what I am interested in. We the people. And then they go coax politician. I might support a politician because of policy. But then they go coax them and the minute I see if they go the other way, where they benefit with people. Of course, I am no longer your man. It is about the people. It has to be about the people. Politicians, they always want quick results, especially when they want fool with people. Then, quick, they want results. Kotia, putia. Because why? Then get the electorate, then for please. And I don't want you. Election, they come. I don't want you. And I'm warning you again. Election, they come. Now, I make a cut to the Andes by Koma. I arrest one. I say, it's like saying a game nine and they play between we. Like I said, the former president may not talk about a need for say more. Because it looked like saying he was pushed so much to a point that he didn't get for come out and talk. But who knows? This could be part of the script. Can I just read a few comments, you know, please. And allow me to read a few comments before I close the program. James Abdullah Conte, I will just start from James. No, Janet. National interest, not tribalism or regionalism. We demand inclusion and equal. That's what we're talking about, social justice. That's why it is. Many thanks, sister. James Abubakar Conte, what happened to the stolen $1.5 million from Chief Minister? That's a good question. And I promise you, Mr. Ibrahim, Mr. Conte, are they come to that? That program they get for come on this particular platform. It's not dead and gone. And here is the thing. One people, they say that they fed corruption. And then you get questions being asked of senior government officials. And to this day, a thorough answer has not been provided. That case they just sweep them under the table. But I can tell you, say, outrightly, that the press secretary to the president, and I don't forget the other name, actually make we for understand, say, the president, somebody, I talk on the last time, somebody say, Prince, be careful, you know, you're not something serious, you can say. But of course, I'm serious. And because the president get interest in the case, so therefore, all that case they gone under the carpet. And she knows under the carpet, anything in Carnegie is that carpet here. So we just want to let people know. So Maxivan Davis, another dimension could be deliberate. The reality on the ground, the bread and butter economy, is a woeful failure and hence reasons for an orchestrated drama to blame the other side of subterfuge. I absolutely agree with his submission, Maxivan. And this is now one of me theory then, you know, for this particular case, because you compile the case and try to make sense out of X and Y in that equation there. Waiting line at the middle. In other words, the president, the former president say, well, I'm willing to comply. And for a couple of times when I don't try them, this ACC boss determined say, well, I get for being this president, ex-president come. But from waiting the police, then they tell we and other security apparatus in the country, it doesn't sum up. It not sum up at all. And with the AEC demand me for make statement, tell his supporter and say, well, not all Unade. Unage for forgive me because this is actually laughable, like my sister said earlier. It's a comedy, a complete comedy. And it don't become a drama, just like some American, you know, yeah, kind of drama. And President X Kuma for make statements and not send call, not owner the same call. So una stay. Are you serious? And some people that one believe say a case of this magnitude, not get interference from White House, from State House. Are you serious? You must be daydreaming or you're on an ego trip. I absolutely agree with you, brother. Prince Madabio is already a failure. If election be called now, he will hands down. This is where we need to be careful, Mr. Kabo. Let's be honest about it. I'm not saying the process of electioneering, manipulating, and cooking is ongoing now. So it's not as easy as the way how you put them. The way how you put them, if it were to be a one-to-one, it's no rocket science because the president is unpopular. That's just a fact. He's unpopular by virtue of his economic policies. And etc. Things are not just working. I just talk about £1 na 13,000 euros. They're not good at all. They're not good at all for we people because even the businessmen, they're not good for them because they just survive on the bare minimum. But again, for letting the survivor and continue to provide goods and services to the people, then they pass the buck on to the people. They wait, they go back to the people. So it's the people where they suffer in this regard. That's why the people, they need for wise up and be prepared. They need for wise up and be prepared. Political education, they come soon. It's the duty of the conscious for conscientize the unconscious. And this is what we are doing. Sister Janet, government is about continuity and shadowing is necessary. Everything with the sister say every time just make complete sense. Did you hear that? It's continuity, not to event, and a good for shadow. I hope so we understand our connotation in there. A good for shadow. Thank you very much for that. They remove experience from amateurs. I think that's another problem again, and this comes from Brother Said Kamara. You see, the great Sierra Leone People's Party, I call it the great Sierra Leone People's Party, is made up of men and women of towering heights. Towering heights, they look the emphasis, I tell you. But we know, say, what we get is different from that body structure they will be talk about. And we see in the people the way they serve. So that dysfunction there alone, never allow the party in government for reaching height and provide and produce within the Sierra Leonean people they need. But that is of their own making. James Abubakar Conte Mara will soon join the OTP Association in the world. Come 2023, we're gonna vote him out with impunity. Okay. Cronyism is the reason for the ineffectiveness. They don't have the training. Many thanks again to Jane. Boy Jalo Jamboria, another academic. Solve the issue of political appointments by decentralization and other public management approaches. Absolutely, sir. So there are key things that they are supposed to do. But I go back again to a comment with somebody made, where if you not get the expertise there, the people that we necessary, we get where we are. How do they know this? This is what the problem is, Mr. Jamboria. Many thanks for that contribution. Brain indeed. I think that was in response to Mr. Jamboria. Masiba, one of the major miscalculations was to disband or cancel all those mining projects when they assume office. People lost their jobs and vital revenues, so the government also gone. This government is broke. I will agree that the government is broke and the government is struggling. Economically, they're struggling. You know, this COVID-19 is a blessing in disguise, I must say. Honestly, it's a blessing in disguise. In terms of canceling the mining licenses, you know, at the time and even now, I thought it was a good move, although it was, there should have been an alternative, but I thought it was a good move. I thought the intent was noble because, mining contracts were signed without due diligence and they were not thorough and proper. And if they were not, or not efficient, not effective, in fact, they were inefficient and ineffective. To make them efficient and effective, government had to cancel those licenses and renegotiate. But of course, it wasn't an easy task. And what I'm beginning to understand now, that there was some selfish nature in it. And we even doing a documentary soon on the city of, not Tumbo, Lonsa, the mining town of Lonsa. Because we're beginning to understand like the cheap way they did now out of greed and the community where they did, where they self get land, where they use for mine. Now money business come back inside. It's deep anyway. I'm on it. As soon as that work is complete, we will be and come, you know, here live. Central Camara, for sure. True talk. Thank you very much. This now my brother Trevor. Do bad, so good may come out of it. Those mining contracts were not effectively done, hence the reason. I just said it. I absolutely agree. Came out, you know, had, you know, issues with good friends who saw it otherwise. But this is not the thing. We don't necessarily get for agree. We can disagree for agree. We are not enemies. Yeah, if I not support one policy and I get good reason why, you don't have to look at me as an enemy. Let's look at the issue. Let's look at substance. Political cataract. Goodness me. When you lack the acumen to lead, effectiveness can never be realized. Let's talk effectiveness for Prince. Cronyism is everywhere, even in Western democracies. That is politics. People support and fund parties and presidents because they want favors over other competitors. It doesn't mean they are not fit or qualified for the contract. It's just that blah, blah, blah. Seymour, when favors over others is everywhere. Okay, we take that on. So I've canceled those contracts was a bad mistake. Okay, yes, we get the benefit of hindsight now, but the intent didn't look like a good intent. We still look into RAM. The former president's statement regarding his desire to cooperate is fake. That is just something that he wants to portray himself as fighting against. And this is where I will ask question, Mr. Trevor, how do you know it's fake? If you can substantiate evidence, be it circumstantial or physical, we will let for talk about that, not on this program tonight, but on another program. Pure speculation. Okay, I think the sister just addressing that, pure speculation. When the BO government will give an account of the COVID-19 fund, of course, that day will come. Accountability and transparency is the hallmark going forward. Now, IMEC will say, okay, the president has set a precedent, so let's see what's going to happen going forward. So now, on that basis, they are to say that they will come, of course. They will be accountable. Prince, you have to be sure of the president's interest in that corruption case. Evidence will be very good for the people of Sierra Leone. Yes, Mr. Parker, I know we talked about, this came up the other day. We'll see what happens. I still work on the case. And assure of my source, 99.99% sure of my source, but I will talk about that on another day. How do you know there is election malpractices already? These allegations are far-fetched. Always make a statement that you are prepared to. Of course, Mr. Parker, I'll touch on that quickly. Whilst it can be largely circumstantial, and circumstantial not mean say it not get gravitas, of course, so you therefore understand the manipulation of elections, the stage where it can be and how they can manipulate them. So let's go back again to parliament. Let me come up parliament. Let's talk about the demography. Let me talk about midterm census and the case behind midterm census. That's what you need for go read and try to understand deeply, Mr. Parker. And then probably you might have a different take on it. But this is where you begin the manipulation process. And then you see what can be happening with NEC. You see the chairman now, the president of NEC. Who do you think he is? Why did you think he got a job? Go do that investigation there. Okay? So, you know, so now all them things and they get for day into place. And furthermore, as we go on, you will see the police units, them, the chiefs them of the security apparatus, all will be changed to favor government. That's just what the process is, brother. But thanks for bringing that up. Said Kamara, it's not the same concern the ACC used to cancel the previous two meetings. Why isn't it resolved before trying to engage the man? Absolutely, Mr. Kamara. So why they not resolve that? Or what happened? Did they resolve them before they put out another? Okay. So I can go on reading. The messages are many, but a boy Jamboya. Okay. Let me read the brother in last comments. And Raymond Gaba. South Korea that built the city hall has no known minerals. Mining contract must not be an issue if we are ready to develop. Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. We don't come for rely on them. I mean, that's foolishness. Foolish pride. I haven't seen anything bad to investigate ex-president. Let's forget about politics. This has also happened in any developed country around the world. That's from brother Raymond Gaba. This name looks new to me on the platform. Okay, so I'll stop there because we've gone far too much into the program. It was meant to be an hour's program. It's now an hour and 20 minutes. So let's see whether I can wrap them up in about 5 minutes' time. Okay? Let's see whether I can wrap them up in 5 minutes' time. Okay. So, Fambulen, the political pressure for one for change things by virtue of unrealistic dates can left government in a limbo. Like this short time we don't let, this is what I'm speaking to. Government go out and back on projects that we have not promised on. They might even come and start laying foundations which are not going to be feasible, but these are election promises before or the then, and in the now going into our new elections, those promises get for appear like say they have been fulfilled. So we will see all of these, like the bridge, the Lunge Bridge project, like the Bekri project, like the new airport project, who we'll therefore talk about lengthily. $350 million contract. Shell, mind you, that was never canceled. Shell, wait for don't give me a new hub. Go for compete with waiting, like waiting Ghana, they do so now. And we had the opportunity before Ghana. Ghana's one is newer than ours would have been. Like how we can go suffer and struggle in Morocco when a hub, all different flights can meet the different people. How much money will we not make there? And the easing of the pressure on Freetown, in which all of the services are thoroughly exhausted, whether in Aguma Valley, whether in the electricity, who they talk about, and the government continue to feel the pinch. So I hear somebody when they talk about badges where they go rent, like ship them where they go rent. I had a problem with the ship the way and has been going. But later I begin to understand, because even serious countries like Ghana and few other countries, when you output capacity in terms of electricity for development does not meet the requirement, you resort to alternatives for keep them going in the meantime while you fix others. So that is what was happening. So this government come back again and fire that ship they forgo, and then the ship go middle water, then go re-sign contract and bring the same ship again. With all that things that will be there, just for make the people and they get by. So let me say there is hope down the tunnel that some of the actions taken by this government, now for the long term, not for the short term, but how much patience have we got? How much patience have we got? Wherever we look, we get a huge opportunity there, yeah? That even include we own country. We as a people need for come together and help we country, and government need for understand this and stop for play game with we. This government look too effective and too weak. Did you hear me? Too effective and too weak. And don't say why they contemplate on this word, too effective and too weak. Let's be honest. But now I feel free for pull and ado for say I'm right now the platform. And then one day we get yes for you, then you, because I don't make the case already. This then they come out of personal feelings, but on the basis of the evidence we available. If your policy is too weak, you get ineffective policies, inefficient policies. And everything I saw about what you do is inequitable. That's just the fact. Take Ernest Kouroma, if you want to try him, if you see us about go try him. Why do you want to take him to Freetown anyhow, Gloucester Street, as congested as Freetown is, with the support where they get it? If not to game sooner, they play with me. Both you and Ernest Kouroma, both the SLPP and the APC, or EBK and JMB. And with the full support of them, we did they make noise. The last time, the Thursday, if you see where people and they celebrate, when finally the Thursday don't come, I don't know what's so personal, you know, here for people in this, when we are being tricked. And like I say, my good friend Kutubu all get carried away in this. And you know, we talk about 3 hours from 1 a.m. to about 4 in the morning on this issue on the Thursday. In the end, they say, bro, you wait and see this Thursday, waiting to happen. Now I tell them, look, I'm live. Nothing not get for happen, at least not this Thursday. The man is powerful. The man get money, so he can employ lawyer there. So this thing where they float the idea again about warrant of arrest. This deliberately come up from them, the authority them, then float the idea once more again for mislead we, because waiting them until we say they happen, not happen. So they float the idea. This time we go issue warrant of arrest. Issue warrant of arrest for what? For what? You summon the man not turn up, the man sending lawyers then. Pass you until we say now we don't get right for sending lawyers then. But what should they issue the warrant of arrest for? The man is not refusing to go. All along, he keep the site issues. And then, when accept the shoot, when accept not the foot, with security reasons, inside the same Freetown, they will not see the man for telling supporter there for letting not come out. Are you serious? A lawyer come out, you see the disabled people there all day being them. Because this is not the nature of us. Before they talk about inside Central Freetown, and they come out, are you serious? Something must be wrong. And that has to be right. You can fool some people sometimes, but you cannot fool all the people all of the time. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of this wonderful broadcast. Just a quick reminder, tomorrow we get Mr. Mohamed Kamara, Superman. Pardon me, I think I go there on the panel as well. But we will be having the president of SLAJ, the Sierra Leone Association of Journalists. The president will be on this platform tomorrow, Mr. Saheed Ahmed Nasrallah, aka D. Monk. will be here tomorrow. Also here tomorrow will be the president, the director rather, for media at the University of Sierra Leone, and the former head of the mass communications department at the University of Sierra Leone, Dr. Tonia Musa. These two people will be on live tomorrow on this platform, and we will talk about serious issues, them just like the repealing of the seditious libel law and the replacement, the AIMC. We'll be talking about those two. Generally, press freedom, the inception of social media, public responsibility, communication, and you name it. So don't forget for tuning tomorrow. Watch the platform. We'll put out the flyer again tonight and first thing tomorrow morning, but we will be here. For the then and now, I've been your host and presenter, Prince Emil Krumah.